We want to find the value of the Riemann sum given here for f of x equals negative x squared plus 16 using the partitions p equals 1, 3, 5, and 8, where c sub k is the right endpoint of each partition. Looking at the sum for a moment, notice how it will be summing the product of f of c and delta x using these partitions. So if the function was non-negative over these partitions, we could think of this as summing the area of rectangles, where f of c would be the height and delta x would be the width. But because our function is negative when x is greater than 4, we will have negative values for f of c, and therefore we can't really think of this as area unless we think of the area above the x-axis as positive and the area below the x-axis as negative. Let's begin by setting up the partitions using 1, 3, 5, and 8. Here's where x equals 1. Here's where x equals 3, x equals 5 here, and finally x equals 8. Notice using these values here, we have three partitions. The first two have a width of 2 units, which should be delta x. The third partition has a width of 3 units, which should be delta x. And now we'll form rectangles using the right endpoint of each partition. Looking at this first partition, this would be the height of the rectangle, the right side of the partition. Because this rectangle is above the x-axis, we can think of f of c times delta x as the area of this rectangle. But for the next partition, using the right endpoint, notice how the function value here is negative. So we'll have a rectangle that's below the x-axis that looks like this. And because the function value f of 5 will be negative, we could think of this as a negative area. And then for the last partition, again using the right endpoint, again, the rectangle would be below the x-axis, where we can think of this as the height, even though f of 8 would be a negative function value. And therefore, f of c times delta x is going to be negative. So we can think of the area of this rectangle as a positive area. And if it's helpful, we can think of the area of these two rectangles as negative. Even though we know area can never be negative, it is one way to view this. One thing we should notice though, because the area of the rectangles below the x-axis is greater than the area of the rectangle above the x-axis, the value of the Riemann sum should be negative. Let's set this up using function notation and then we'll find the value. So we'd have v equals, for this first partition, using the right endpoint, we'd have f of 3, the height of the rectangle, times delta x of the width, which is 2 units, plus looking at the second rectangle, the height would be f of 5, even though that would be negative. The width or delta x would be 2 units, plus looking at the third partition, again we're using the right side, so we can think of the height as f of 8, though it would be negative, times delta x of the width, which is 3 units. Next, we'll determine the function values, f of 3, f of 5, and f of 8, using f of x equals negative x squared plus 16. So for f of 3, since 3 squared is 9, we'd have negative 9 plus 16, that's 7. So we have 7 times 2, plus for f of 5, since 5 squared equals 25, this would be negative 25 plus 16, which would be negative 9, so we have negative 9 times 2. And then finally we have f of 8 times 3. F of 8 would be negative 64 plus 16. That'd be negative 48 times 3. Which means we have 14 plus, this would be negative 18, plus this would be negative 144. So the value of the Riemann sum would be negative 148. I hope you found this helpful.